friends, in the previous lecture we start with the chapter number 17, that is circle, chord and arc. Also we have completed the practice set 17.1. Now in the lecture, the next point of the chapter that we are going to start here, and that is arcs corresponding to chord of a circle. So all we know, what is chord in the circle? See in the figure, here segment AB is a chord of a circle here. Now, due to this chord, we get a two arcs, that is arc AYB is a major arc and arc AXB, it's a minor arc. As we say, this O is the center of circle. So all you can understand, AYB is a major arc and AXB is the minor arc. Now see, in the same circle, due to the chord AB, we get a two arcs. So arc AYB and arc AXB are called corresponding arcs of chord AB. So what we say here, due to the chord AB, there are two arcs are formed, that is the arc AYB and arc AXB. So these two arcs are corresponding arcs. Now, also we can say the chord AB's corresponding chord of arc AYB and arc AXB. So see, the thing is written here, arc AXB is a minor arc, arc AYB is a major arc. So arc AXB and arc AYB are called corresponding arc of chord AB. In another word, same thing we can say like that. Chord AB is corresponding chord of arc AXB and AYB. So I hope all you understand about the corresponding arc as well as corresponding chord in a circle. Now look at the next important point of the chapter, that is the congruence of arc. If two arcs are given, how they can be a congruent, that we have to understand here. So very easy way. First we say that if the measure of two arcs are same, then that the two arcs are congruent. See in the figure here. Here we have two arcs, that is AXB and arc DYC. So these are the two minor arcs. If angle AOB is equal to the angle DOC, like that, then we say the arc AXB and arc DYC have the same measure. That means the arc AXB and arc DYC are congruent arcs, right? So we have written here the thing, that is measure of arc AOB is equal to measure of arc DOC, then measure of arc AXB, that is equal to measure of arc BYC, and therefore arc AXB and arc DYC are congruent arc. One more thing that we have to remember here, the chords corresponding to the congruent arc, they are also equal, right? If the arc AXB and arc DYC are equal or congruent, then chord AB and BC also congruent. Therefore, we write here chord AB is congruent to chord BC. One more thing. Every arc like that AXB is measures equal to its corresponding central angle. This arc measures equal to this angle. This arc also measures equal to this angle. That means every arc have a same measure that of their corresponding central angle. So this is the few important point that we have to remember in the class. After this we are going to solve the practice set 17.2. Now look at the problem set 17.2. In the problem 17.2, we have the first question given here, that is, in a figure, diameter PQ and diameter SR perpendicular to each other at a center C of the circle. Then prove that RPS, this RPS congruent to RSQ. So very first, see, if diameter PQ and diameter SR, they are perpendicular to each other, this is given here. Therefore, measure of angle PCS, this, and measure of angle QCS, this, they both are 90 degree. Therefore, measure of angle PCS is equal to measure of angle QCS. And therefore, measure of arc, corresponding arc, that is PS and SQ, these have the same measure. That means they are congruent to each other. Similarly, the arc RQ, the arc RP are congruent to arc PS that I have written here. Now look at the second question of practice set 17.2. which is the last question of this chapter as well as your syllabus. In the question, we have given this figure. MN is a diameter and there are some radii are given, that is AO, BO, CO, DO. These are the radii. And we have given some measures of central angles. Then we have to find the measure of angle. Look at here, AOB and angle COB. So these two angles we have to find. Very first, see, measure of angle AOB, which we have to find, we consider that is X. This measure of angle AOB is what? X. Now, measure of angle MON, MON. This angle is a 180 degree because it's a straight angle. Now see how this angle is formed with this 135 and x. Therefore we write 100 plus x plus 35, that is equal to 180. When we solve this, 100 plus 35, that is 135 plus x is equal to 180, shift this here. So x is equal to 180 minus 135. So x is equal to 45 degree. That means angle AOB is 45 degree. Similarly, as we solve for this angle here, DOC. So angle DOC or COD is also 45 degree. If these two angles are having same measure, that is 45 degree and 45 degree, their corresponding arcs AB and CD are congruent. AB and CD arcs are congruent. This is our second question there. And due to this, the corresponding chord AB and corresponding chord CD, they are also equal. So chord AB and CD, they are also equal, the corresponding chords, corresponding arcs.